Hey, it's Bill the Handyman up here in Northern California. How are you all doing today? Today we're looking at a old school Vitamix 3600. And this has the reversing blade switch action. We're just gonna clean it up and lube it a little bit. Put like a drop oil on some of the moving parts. See if we can make it run a little bit better. There are four screws that hold the bottom plate on. And let's see, there are four screws, the Phillips screws inside that hold this top piece on. Like that seal's a little worn. But what we're gonna focus on right now is, now these bearings, it looks like there's a felt underneath this cap here. So what we're gonna do is take this cap off and lube that felt in there that feeds that bearing. I'm pretty sure there's going to be a felt under there. If there's not a felt, it's going to be a way to remove this bearing or bushing. It's actually a bushing. This is, of course, your mini breaker in the system. This will trip, apparently, when it's overloaded. And so, you can check these with an ohmmeter to make sure they have continuity in case your machine's not working. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to clean these brushes, the armature up. You can see how the armature has a dull color to it. We're going to kind of brighten it up so it's going to have a copper color to it. Okay, let's get started. First thing I'm going to do is try and take this bearing cap off, and it's on there pretty tight. I'm going to need two hands to do this. Okay, so this bushing cap is only you need to take one screw off. You can see the felt in there, that white stuff there. And what I like to use is this is tri-flow lubricant. It has Teflon in it. It helps to make bushings and bearings last a long time. What I will sometimes do is spray a little bit of that inside my oiler and mix it with different premium blends of oil and use that as a lubricant as well. In order to access this top bushing, we may have to take the top off. And as a matter of fact, I think I can see it right there. And so we're going to focus on this for now. I'm going to lube that and then put that bearing cap on, back on. And then we're going to try and clean up the commutator connections right there. Okay, so these four Phillips screws here and there will take the motor out in case you need to replace the motor. So what I've done is I've got some Scotch-Brite here, scrubber, and I put a little bit of solvent on it. You can use alcohol or electrical parts cleaner. And basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to move the motor at the same time I'm going to rub the armature with this and clean it up. And this will help the motor run a little bit more efficiently. And as far as lubing the top bearing, if you have a oiler or some lubricant with a nozzle on it, you can spray it down in here and that will lube that bearing. There's also a seal under here that, as you can see, it's sort of hardened up, but it's not a crucial item. This seal is only good if your seal on your blender top is leaking down through here. So now we're going to clean up this armature here and make it nice and shiny. Okay, so I cleaned up the armature. You can see it's a lot prettier looking. You can actually use carburetor cleaner or WD-40. You do not want to use steel wool because the steel particles will get in there and anything that's magnetized it will stick to steel wool will stick to it. So I always use this kind of stuff. It's like the Scotch-Brite scrubber stuff. And so, yeah, so this puppy is sort of reconditioned at this point. The brushes are still good. Simply to replace the brushes, we just need to remove these two screws here and here and pull out the brushes, but I'm not going to do that today. I was able to lube these switches slightly here, and so this one is ready to rock and roll for another year possibly. Thanks for watching. If you need any help, you can contact me at MrMaintain@hotmail.com, 707-443-8347 Pacific Time.